The first half of 19th century was a very bad time for Indian textile industry. But the second half of the 19th century brought up some textile mills in India. So that is why the topic is cotton mills come. So the first cotton mill was set up in Bombay in the year 1854, and it was set up in the form of spinning mill. Now since Bombay was very near to sea, so Bombay used to export raw cotton to Britain and China before setting up of cotton mill. And later on, when Bombay set up its own cotton mill, it was easy for Bombay to get raw material, that is cotton, because Bombay is very close to the cotton growing tract of Maharashtra and Gujarat. So because it is cotton grows well in black soil, so that is why of Western India, the Bombay can get raw material easily for their cotton mills. Now after that, from 1900, in the year 1900, almost 84 mills were set up in Bombay, and most of these mills were set up by Parsi and Gujarati businessmen who earned a lot of money by trading with China. Now in 1861, in Ahmedabad also mills were made, and in 1862 Kanpur also, in Kanpur also, that is in Uttar Pradesh or previously United Province, there also cotton mills started coming up. And with the growth of mills in India, the demand for labor started increasing. Now the poor peasants, the artisans, the agricultural laborers, they all started moving to these cities in search of job. Now in the first few decades of setting up of cotton mills, India faced some problems. The problems were, it has to compete with the machine made goods of the Britain. So it was very difficult to compete with cheap textiles that was imported from Britain. Then mostly it happens that when new industries are set up, the government gives protection to those industries by either stopping the import of goods from other countries or by imposing heavy duties on the imported goods. So the imported good will become costly and the local made goods will be cheap. So that is why protection was given to many countries. But in India, such protection was denied by the British government. If it would have been an Indian government, surely the Indian cotton textile mills would have got protection. But since it was British government, they refused any such protection to the local industries. And so in the early years, it was difficult for the cotton textile mills to flourish. But a sudden change occurred during the First World War. Because during the First World War, the import of cotton from Britain started declining, and the need for more and more cotton made in India was felt. So the first spurt or the first change or the first increase in the production of cotton textile industries started during the First World War, when the textile imports from Britain declined and the Indian factories were asked to produce cloths for military supplies. So for the military uniforms, such cotton clothes were used, and many types of military uniforms they required. Moreover, the military equipments were packed in the cotton bags. So the demand of cotton increased, and the Indian cotton industry started developing during the First World War.